From the desktop, select the Mach-1 motion shortcut icon, and then select the proper configuration file for your system. In this case, it's V500C with one vertical stitch. Press the start button, and then Mach-1 motion is now initialized. The Mach-1 motion window consists of different configuration options on the left, below, as well as the two main graphs. The top graph displays the positions of the stages in real time, and the bottom graph displays the loads of the currently active load cells. When using a multiple axis load cell, for example, both the forces and torques are available, showing six inputs. The lower configuration panel consists of setup options as well as general information. The sampling rate determines the rate at which data is acquired, and eight different sampling rates are available. The higher rates will create larger data files. Clicking the manual controls button will open a window that allows manual control of each stage's displacement. As each stage can move rapidly, be careful not to overload the load cell during this process by accidental metal-on-metal contact. On multi-axis systems, the user must choose which axis to move from the drop-down menu, and then three preset velocities are available, high, medium, and low. Clicking and holding a direction button results in the displacement of the corresponding stage in the chosen direction. For example, position Z in the up direction. Avoid fast, repetitive clicking of the displacement buttons for more precision, as all clicks result in displacements. Clicking the axis midpoint button will find the midpoint of the selected axis. The midpoint is an absolute reference. Upon reaching the midpoint, the motion controller will set the position to zero, as you can see up here. Before choosing the axis midpoint command, make sure that the selected stage is always completely free to move along the displacement range. This to make sure that the action will not overload the load cell accidentally. Clicking the axis power on button will turn the stage motor on corresponding to the axis. This may be required after overload detections or upon receiving errors from the motion controller. Clicking the zero load button will set the current load read by the load cell back to zero. And on multi-axle systems, all load components will be zeroed at the same time. Clicking the zero position button will set the current position read by the selected axis as the new zero. For example, we'll use the camera to clarify this next part. Clicking the load cell button will open a window that allows the selection and calibration of a load cell, as well as the selection of a low-pass filter to reduce the noise in the load signal. All the available load cells will be listed, and the activated column will indicate which load cell is activated. Double-clicking any load cell will activate it, and only one can be activated at a time. The other three columns are produced automatically after a calibration procedure. To calibrate a load cell, click the Calibrate button. This will open a new window where a calibration weight can be selected from a drop-down list. The names of these calibration weights are usually written on the weight themselves, or on the bag that the weight came in. For this method, I will click the Calibrate button, and then follow the instructions on screen. I will first install the calibration holder, being careful not to overload the load cell. And then I will place the calibration weight into the middle portion. The load cell is now calibrated, and the calibration factor is always supposed to be within 5% of 1.00, so between 0.95 and 1.05. The second calibration method is to insert the weight directly into the load cell. For this, I will select the proper calibration weight, click Calibrate, and then follow the instructions on screen. Always be careful when installing anything into the load cell. Sometimes prudent to keep an eye on the load cell window to see how much force you are putting on the load cell currently. Okay. To remove the calibration weight, I usually keep one hand at a distance from the weight and then let it drop into that hand. The load cell is now calibrated. calibrate a multi-axis load cell, we'll open the load cell window, select the appropriate load cell, and then click calibrate. To start, we'll use the calibration holder and install this on the load cell. We will then install the calibration weight onto one of the sides of the calibration holder. Following the instructions on screen will give us a calibration factor within 5% of 1.00. The second method to calibrating the multi-axis load cell is to select calibrate and select a threaded weight, and following the instructions on screen. Calibration weight will be placed into the side insert on the multi-axial load cell. The instructions will be followed on screen, being careful not to damage this load cell. And the calibration factor will again be within 5% of 1.00, as in from 0.95 to 1.05. Clicking the User Manual button provides access to a PDF file of the Mach-1 User Manual. Clicking the About button provides information on which software version you have, as well as other information related to your Mach-1. To facilitate the identification of your system when writing to Biomomentum, click the Copy to Clipboard button, and you can now paste this information elsewhere. A camera feed can be added to the Mach-1 so that image capture can be synchronized with the raw data of the mechanical test. Clicking the Show Camera button reveals a secondary panel displaying the camera feed as well as the related parameters. Clicking the Snapshot button will save an image. Activating the Recording checkbox here will record video during data acquisition, and the frame interval is the time between saved images and the video. The minimum interval is 0.1 seconds. The ideal parameters for the camera settings are unchecking all three frame rate, gain, and shutter, setting the frame rate at 10 frames per second, the shutter at 100 milliseconds, and the gain at its maximum. You can then readjust using the lens. Clicking the Hide Camera button will switch back to the regular panel. The top line on the panel indicates the status of the Mach-1. The normal messages that will be shown are idle when the system is not in use, and busy when a sequence is running. Error messages and notifications will also be shown here. Some possible messages are following error threshold exceeded. This is when the controller was unable to keep track of the stage's position. Positive and negative hardware limits detected, for example. Maximum velocity exceeded. When the maximum velocity of the stage was reached and the stage will stop moving, as well as maximum acceleration exceeded, when the maximum acceleration of the stage was reached and the stage will stop moving. The function menu is a drop-down list of all the available functions that can be used to build a sequence to perform a test. As each function is selected, the corresponding configurable parameters with their according units are displayed. For each function, the user must specify both the stage axis as well as the load cell axis, and failure to match these two can result in damage to the load cell because the stop criteria might never be met, for example.